Once upon a time,
in the faraway land of ancient Greece, there was a golden age of powerful gods and extraordinary heroes. And the greatest and strongest of all these heroes was the mighty Hercules. But what is the measure of a true hero? Now, that is what our story
Will
is
about. Will you listen to him? He's making this story sound like some Greek tragedy.
Lighten up, dude.
We'll take it from here, darling.
You go, girl.
We are the muses, goddesses of the arts, and proclaimers of heroes.
Heroes like Hercules.
Honey, you mean Hercules. Woohoo, I'd like to make some sweet music
Our
with
Our story actually begins long before Hercules, many eons ago. Back when the world was new. The planet Earth was down on its luck, and everywhere gigantic brutes called Titans ran amok.
It was a nasty place. There was a mess wherever you stepped,
where chaos reigned and earthquakes and volcanoes never slept.
Woo! Sand girlfriend!
And then along came Zeus. He hurled his thunderbolt. He's out.
Locked those suckers in a vault.
They're trapped.
There was a little ogre named Shrek, who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy, because ogres like nasty. On his birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly.
Now you're seven, so it's time to go away. Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip.
Your papa packed your boots in case of snow.
You're gonna make us proud, no backing up allowed.
Just keep walking.
Just keep walking, and you'll find. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true. But not for you. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. And just around the bend, not for you.
We're ugly, son, which means that life is harder. People hate the things they cannot understand.
And when they look at us, they tend to make a fuss.
Burn our houses down.
And chase us.
A place no one would ever dare to tread.
And if they happen by, make sure you terrify them.
If you don't, son,
then you'll surely wind up dead.
And so, The little ogre went off and found a muddy patch of swampland far, far away from the world that despised him. And there he stayed for many years, tucked away and all alone, which was just the way he liked it.
Listen, they're beautiful, no? So many colors of sound, so many changing moods. Because, you know, they do not ring all by themselves.
They don't?
No, you silly boy. Up there, high, high in the dark bell tower, lives the mysterious bell ringer. Who is this creature?
Who?
What is he?
What?
How did he come to be there?
How?
Hush! Clopin will tell you. It is a tale. A tale of a man and a monster. Dark was the night when our tale was begun. On the docks near Notre Dame.
Shut it up, will you? We'll be spotted!
Hush, little one.
Four frightened gypsies slid silently under the docks near Notre Dame.
4 guilders for safe passage into Paris.
But a trap had been laid for the gypsies, and they gazed up in fear and alarm at a figure whose clutches were iron as much as the bell.
Judge Claude Frollo, the bell.
Of Notre Dame. Judge Claude Frollo longed to purge the world of vice and sin. And he saw corruption everywhere except within.
Bring these gypsy vermin to the Palace of Justice.
You there! What are you hiding?
Stolen goods, no doubt. Take them from her.
She ran. Deacon.
This is an unholy demon. I'm sending it back to hell, where it belongs.
See there the innocent blood you have spilt on the steps of Notre Dame.
I am guiltless. She ran, I pursued.
Now you would add this child's blood to your guilt on the steps of Notre Dame.
My conscience is clear.
You can lie to yourself and your minions. You can claim that you haven't a qualm. But you never can run from nor hide what you've done from the eyes, the very eyes of Notre Dame.
And for one time in his life of power and control, Frollo felt a twinge of fear for his immortal soul.
What must I do?
Care for the child and raise it as your own.
What? I am to be saddled with this misshapen. Very well. But let him live with you in your church.
Live here? Where?
Anywhere. Just so he's kept locked away where no one else can see. The bell tower, perhaps. And who knows, our Lord works in mysterious ways. Even this foul creature may yet prove one day to be of use to me.
And Frollo gave the child a cruel name.
This is a story.
A name that means half-formed.
There is worse on the beautiful, the princess. The cheers and what's it in an enchantress, the pawn pawned it for the beautiful shorts, which can only be broken for a true love first kiss. Children, she was locked always and in the castle, Garsman and Very Tale Fire Brilly Breaking Dragon.
As odds spat to the frayed hands from this dream of perdition. Happy birthday, press. Bernard Ricardale. She whisked in the dragon skins in the high room of Tradis' tower for the true love and true love first kiss.
She's beautiful.
He's no ordinary monster. He's a lizard with a heart of gold. Don't believe the lies you've been told. He's a fire-breathing child to me. I see sweetness when I look into those large yellow eyes. He's got a sensitive stare, one that can hypnotize. He may be rough on the outside, but inside,
I hate to be seen.
Child, he's the kind I've ever met. And
see how nice his head stays on.
I'll be there for you.
Wow, he's sharing Wawa.
Forever and a day.
Keep your big bright and unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and shove it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created. But I don't care, 'cause being liked is grossly overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I've got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine.